of God. And it's the grace of God which has gathered us together and forgives our sins. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy. From the letter to the Thessalonians. As for loving our brothers, there is no need for anyone to write to you about that, since you have learned from God yourselves to love one another. And in fact, this is what you are doing with all the brothers throughout the whole of Macedonia. However, we do urge you, brothers, to go on making even greater progress and to make a point of living quietly, attending to your own business and earning your living, just as we told you to. The word of the Lord.
The Lord comes to rule the people with fairness. The Lord comes to rule the people with fairness. Sing a new song to the Lord, for he has worked wonders. His right hand and his holy arm have brought salvation. The Lord comes to rule the people with fairness. Let the sea and all within it thunder, the world and all its peoples. Let the rivers clap their hands, and the hills ring out their joy at the presence of the Lord. The Lord comes to rule the people with fairness. For the Lord comes, he comes to rule the earth. He will rule the world with justice and the peoples with fairness. The Lord comes to rule the people with fairness. Because you are offering it the word of life. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man on his way abroad summoned his servants and entrusted his property to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, each in proportion to his ability. Then he set out. The man who had received the 5 talents promptly went and traded with them and made 5 more. The man who had received 2 made 2 more in the same way. But the man who had received 1 went off and dug a hole in the ground and hid his master's money. Now a long time after, the master of those servants came back and went through his accounts with them. The man who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 more. Sir, he said, you entrusted me with 5 talents. Here are 5 more that I have made. His master said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have shown you can be faithful in small things. I will trust you with greater. Come and join in your master's happiness. Next, the man with 2 talents came forward. Sir, he said, you entrusted me with 2 talents. Here are 2 more that I have made. His master said to him, well done, good and faithful servant. You have shown you can be faithful in small things. I will trust you with greater. Come and join in your master's happiness. Last came forward the man who had 1 talent. Sir, said he, I heard you were a hard man, reaping where you had not sown and gathering where you had not scattered. So I was afraid, and I went off and hid your talent in the ground. Here it is, it was yours, you have it back. But his master answered him, you wicked and lazy servant, so you knew that I reap where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered. Well then, you should have deposited my money with the bankers, and on my return I would have recovered my capital with interest. So now, take the talent from him, and give it to the man who has 5 talents. For to everyone who has will be given more, and he will have more than enough. But from the man who has not, even what he has will be taken away. As for this good-for-nothing servant, throw him out into the dark, where there will be weeping and grinding of teeth. The Gospel of the Lord. I was just reflecting this morning because today is formally the 3rd anniversary of my appointment here as your parish priest. I wonder whether the bishop thinks, well done, good and faithful servant, you have shown yourself faithful in small things, I will trust you with greater, come and join your master's happiness, or whether he's thinking, you wicked and lazy servant, so you knew I reap where I have not sown and gather where I have not scattered. And I hope he's not going to throw me out where there will be weeping and grinding of teeth. He's coming to see me on the 21st of September, so I'll find out. To love God without loving our neighbour is deficient, and may well be insufficient for our entry into the kingdom of God. Indeed, naturally, it would be odd to love our Father but not to love our brothers and sisters. And so supernaturally, we must also therefore love our brothers and sisters in Christ. It will, as we hear at the end of Matthew's Gospel, form part of our judgment. Whatsoever you do unto the least of my brothers, you do unto me. In assuming his human nature, Jesus Christ has united himself supernaturally to our humanity. It's a solidarity that marks us out as one family. Love or charity, it's an indistinguishable mark of our discipleship. By this, all will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another. And this agape love is celebrated in the Eucharist. Greater love have no man that he lay down his life for his friend. Love unites us to God, and it casts a veil over many a sin. Love endures. It does not come to an end. And as St. Augustine says, love is the beauty of the soul, and it is in the soul that will endure after the death of the body, as it looks to take its place in that eternal dwelling which is made ready for our souls in heaven. It is not too late in this life to turn to God in love. And again, as St. Augustine tells us, late have I loved thee, O Lord, and behold, thou wast within, and I without, and there I sought thee. Thou wast with me when I was not with thee. Late have I loved thee, thou beauty ever old and ever new. Thou hast burst my bonds asunder unto thee, will I offer up an offering of praise. And a wonderful offering of praise is to use the gifts that the Lord has given us for his service. O God, to know you is life, to serve you is freedom, says Augustine. To praise you is the soul's joy and delight. In doing what we ought, we deserve no praise, says St. Augustine, because it is our duty. However, in serving the Lord, we will at the end of our own time deserve to hear our Lord say to us, well done, good and faithful servant, come and share your master's joy.
our Lord. For as on the festival of St. Augustine of Hippo, you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Holy be, holy be, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the Holy Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Augustine, St. Monica, St. Mary Magdalene, St. Martha, St. Richard, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis our Pope and Richard our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, for whom you bestow on the world all that is good. For the Saviour's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare. those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter unto my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. So just to remind you, as you come to the distribution of Holy Communion, before you leave at the end of Mass or at the end of Confessions and Adoration, to go to one of the four cleaning stations and take a virus wipe and give your face a clean, leaving it secure for the baptism that follows the Mass and Adoration this lunchtime.
Christ.
Let us pray. May partaking of Christ's table sanctify us, we pray, O Lord, that being made members of his body, we may become what we have received through Christ our Lord. Amen. The offertory boxes by St. Anthony as you leave. The second collection this weekend is for the Parish Charity Fund to help the Food Bank and St. Barnabas' Homeless Unity Group and other charities that need our assistance locally. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the Gospel of the Lord. If you're leaving now, please clean your seats, otherwise you're welcome to stay for adoration and confessions until 11.
Thank you.